Hello, gorgeous people. This is Chris from Macombu, and I'm here with the Motorola Moto G6, the latest Moto G Hero, freshly launched for 2018. And we're going to do a quick unboxing, go through the full setup, explore the software, the hardware, the specs, everything you need to know if you're thinking about buying this blower. So first of all, let's get this lovely green box open. A little bit more about the G6 while we do that. It costs £219 here in the UK, so it's £50 more expensive than this basic bog standard play model and £50 less expensive than the G6 Plus. You'll be able to pick it up at Vodafone here in the UK, and also various retailers such as Amazon will also be stocking it. Let's just give it a good old yank out of here. So there you go, there is the actual phone itself in all of its sheathed glory. Just going to pop that aside for now and check out the rest of the box, of course. So chuck that aside. As you can see, obviously, a nice bit of literature action, a quick start guide in various languages, and the usual boring legal safety stuff shenanigans. As you can see, a pin porky device as well to actually get into the phone, put your SIM card and stuff in there, a 3-pin plug in order to actually charge it up, always handy. And it looks like this bad boy is a Type-C USB as well, as you'd expect at this sort of price point, unlike the basic Play, which is USB 2.0, as I just discovered. And there you go, that is everything you get in the box, some various specs and everything on the back, but don't worry, I'll be going through all of that in full. But first of all, it's good to see that you actually get the protective cover bundled in the box and actually put on the phone for you as well, hooray! Nice little time saver that. Let's just peel it off for now though. It is of course a transparent cover, so at least it doesn't cover up that lovely new glass finish. It is all glass, it's Corning Gorilla Glass 3, so it should hopefully prove quite resistant to scuffs, scratches, and if you drop it, hopefully it won't shatter to bits as well, but don't take my word for that, you'll find out probably in a couple of days because I'm a bit of a butterfingers these days. 167 grams, it's got a decent heft to it as well, and this is the deep indigo version of it. Which is, it's essentially a slightly, ever so slightly bluey version of black. As it catches the light, you can sort of see it's got a bluey tint to it, but it is very dark, so you won't be able to appreciate any sort of bright colouring, but you can also pick it up in blush or silver as well, apparently, so it might be worth checking out one of those finishes instead. All right, it's got a bit of juice in the tank, so we can get it all set up and everything now as well. As you see, it's got the fingerprint sensor mounted here at the bottom of the handset, beneath the screen and beneath this fully fledged Motorola logo as well. So it's not around the back like it was on the Play version. Instead, you just get the standard old school. Hello, Moto. The standard old school Motorola logo, as you can see, has just beneath that dual lens camera.
With the launch of the original Moto G way back in 2014, Motorola absolutely smashed apart the mid-range mobile market. This colourful little smartphone boasted a 720p HD screen, which was technically even sharper than the iPhone 5S's. It also got some pretty nippy performance and a perfectly decent camera, all for just 135 quid. Mental. Fast forward to 2018 and the market has shifted considerably, with lots of smartphone brands such as Honor and Nokia offering some decent little handsets with premium features for under 200 quid, which means plenty of healthy competition for the latest in the G series, the Moto G6. The G family has transformed considerably since the launch of the original. Gone is that colourful, customisable design, replaced with a more refined and mature finish, but on its beaten heart, the G6 still represents great value for money, and it should appease any fairly demanding users who don't have a fat stack. So let's get this out of the way immediately. The Moto G6 is easily one of the best looking smartphones that we've reviewed around this price point. That shiny frame is completely constructed from Gorilla Glass 3, with pleasingly slick results. Of course, like all glass smartphones, the G6 does pick up greasy prints and grime throughout the day. Thankfully, the dark surfacing of this deep indigo model does a pretty good job of masking the smudges, and you can also pick up the phone in a few different hues here in the UK. While the original Moto G was just 4.5 inches in size, the G6 has grown to a whopping 5.7 inches. It's certainly quite the handful, although the curved backing and rounded corners make for a comfortable grip. One-handed use is still a bit of an issue, however, so Motorola has thoughtfully included a screen shrinking feature to compensate. So thankfully you don't have to snap your thumb right out of joint to reach the bloody notifications bar. After a full week of use, our G6 review model is yet to pick up any serious scratches or chips. If you're a bit cack-handed however, Motorola has kindly bundled a transparent protective sheath in the box. The G6 actually comes wrapped in the thing too, so you don't even have to go to the trouble of slapping it on yourself. Lovely stuff. And while the handset isn't fully water resistant like some previous Moto G models, Motorola has added P2i's renowned splash-proof liquid repellent nano-coating technology, bit of a mouthful, inside and out of the phone. We had a few opportunities to test out the G6 in a proper British shower, and a healthy drenching definitely didn't do it any harm at all. Now, Motorola's G series has never disappointed when it comes to the display tech, and the G6 certainly doesn't stumble in this area either. That 5.7-inch IPS panel is the first Moto phone to rock the fashionable 18:9 aspect ratio, which is particularly well suited to movie playback. Images are perfectly crisp despite the generous size thanks to the full HD plus resolution. And colours really pop on the default vibrant mode. You can change that up in the display settings if you do prefer more realistic visuals instead. If you prefer carrying around all of your movies instead of streaming over the web non-stop, then the 32 gigs of storage space is going to fill up rather fast. But good news, the Moto G6 also supports micro SD memory cards of up to 128 gigs in size. And if you do want a bit more built-in storage space, Amazon will reportedly be stocking an exclusive 64GB model right here in the UK. As for audio, that is blasted out of the earpiece alone, and while the maximum volume is strong enough to startle, sound quality is super tinny and a bit flat. We definitely recommend using headphones instead. Thankfully, there is a 3.5mm headphone jack if you want to connect a pair of wired phones, or Bluetooth 4.2 support if you fancy going wireless. Oh, and on the subject of wireless, there is sadly no NFC support built into the Moto G6. You won't be able to use it for your contactless payments anytime soon. Android Oreo is presented on the Moto G6 in its full naked glory. Motorola hasn't smothered it with an overlay to change up the look and feel, and that's all fine and dandy with us. We just hope that the G6 gets Android updates a bit quicker than some of last year's G5 models, which are still waiting on a sweet bit of Oreo. Although this is vanilla Android all the way, Motorola has, as usual, pre-installed its own Moto app. And this adds a fair few bonus features, including plenty of gesture support. For instance, in addition to the aforementioned one-handed mode, you can also quickly screen grab something with a quick swipe of three fingers. The Moto Key feature is an alternative to Google Autofill, using your fingerprint in place of account passwords and the like. In other words, it's a wee bit more secure, as well as a bit more flexible too. And Moto Voice is another alternative option to something, this time the Google Assistant. Quite handy for hands-free access when driving and so on, but it is just as inflexible as the Google Assistant, unfortunately. You'll have to learn some pretty precise commands, or the damn thing won't have a clue what you're on about. For instance, ask what your schedule looks like tomorrow, and you'll helpfully get a Google search on that exact phrase. The Moto G6 is pretty clued up when it comes to security as well. You've got a fingerprint sensor for fast unlocking, although sadly this isn't the funky rear-mounted logo scanner found on the Moto G6 Play. Instead, the standard G6 rocks a narrow sensor around the front, housed beneath that display. Although it's absolutely tiny, I found that the scanner did do a great job of accurately reading my print, no matter which angle I attacked it from. And the reason it's housed around the front is because Motorola has given us the option of using sensor gestures to replace the on-screen navigation bar. You can tap and swipe the scanner to perform the usual back, home, and recent apps commands, thus freeing up a wee bit of space on your desktops. This method of navigating around Android certainly works, and it is surprisingly intuitive, just like Huawei's version in its Emotion UI overlay. That said, the Moto G6's mighty 5.7-inch screen is still perfectly spacious even with that old-school navigation bar crammed in there, so the sensor gestures aren't exactly an essential feature. Still, we're definitely impressed to see Motorola adding its own facial recognition tech to the G-series handsets too. Proper face unlocking tends to only hit more expensive handsets, and the Moto G6 version works in pretty much the same manner. Just tap that power button and make sure the front-facing camera is generally pointed at your mug, and the phone will take a bloody good look at you. If it likes what it sees, you'll skip straight past the lock screen and into your desktops. It's definitely handy if you can't use your fingers to unlock the phone, for instance if you're wearing gloves, and it works pretty well too, although it is quite hit and miss in low light, and it's not as reliable as Huawei's effort for the P20. All the same, it doesn't seem to be baffled by stuff like glasses or a lack of desire to shave, which is definitely commendable. Motorola's shiny new Moto G6 smartphone packs a pleasingly vanilla version of Android Oreo OS, but there are also lots of tasty little bonus features crammed away in there as well, and here are some of our favourites in our in-depth G6 tips and tricks, guys. Now, the Moto G6 ain't exactly easy to handle. It's a full-on 5.7 incher, so you'll really feel it when you're struggling to use it one-handed. But thankfully, Motorola has you covered. All you need to do is dive into the Moto app, and then go to Features, and then Moto Actions. And in there, you'll find the really handy Swipe to Shrink Screen option. You dive into that, it'll show you exactly how to use it. All you need to do is basically make sure that it's toggled on, first of all, and then just swipe with your thumb towards one of the bottom corners. It sometimes takes a little bit of getting used to, sometimes you'll have to swipe a few times to get it to actually work, especially when you're first getting the hang of it. But once you do, it's definitely a great feature. You'll start to be able to do it first time every time, and it's really, really nifty. You can enter all of your apps and use them one-handed as well, so it really, really is very good if you're struggling to, for instance, reach up to the notifications bar. And when you're done, just tap outside and you're back to normal.
Now, while the Moto G6 player has the fingerprint sensor buried away on the back here, it's actually tucked neatly beneath the screen here on the standard Moto G6. And the reason for that is it supports the new fingerprint sense gestures. So if you go into the Moto app, go to Moto Actions, you'll find the one button nav option. What you need to do here is basically just tap this on, and then that will replace the navigation bar here at the bottom of the screen, and you'll be able to use fingerprint sensor gestures instead. Just tap show me how, and it will walk you neatly through it all. So for instance, a quick tap will take you back to the home screen, onto the next. A swipe from right to left will take you back. A swipe from left to right will open up your recent apps. And to go to the lock screen, just hold it for a prolonged period, and so on and so forth. Once you've gone through all of the tutorials, you'll be able to activate it and give it a go. There's not a massive advantage in doing things this way, it just frees up a little bit of space in the screen where the navigation bar used to be, but you do get the hang of the gestures really, really fast, and they do work pretty well, so it's worth giving it a go. Now, the G6's gorgeous 5.7-inch IPS display can be configured in a couple of ways to get it set up just the way you like. If you head into settings and then go to the display section, you'll see that there's color mode in there. If you tap your way into that, you'll see that the vibrant mode is selected by default. That just boosts your colors, makes a bit more vivid for some really nice poppy visuals. But if you prefer more realistic colors instead, for instance, you're going to be editing some photos on the go or something like that, you can drop down to standard. And you can also play around with the color temperature manually if for some reason you want to do that. Now, alternatively, go to the Moto app and head into the Moto display section. And in here, there is the night display mode. This basically just filters blue light and produces nice, warm, easy on the eye visuals between certain times. So for instance, you get it to start at specific times. I prefer to have it start automatically at sunset and then end automatically at sunrise. And that will just make sure that if you're, for instance, checking Facebook at 3 a.m, it's pitch black, you get some nice warm visuals and it doesn't ruin your peepers. Now, that fingerprint sensor is really, really good. It opens to your desktops in just the blink of an eye, and we've tried attacking it from various angles and it seems to work really, really well no matter how you do it. But there is also an alternative option, for instance, if you're wearing gloves or you're working in the kitchen and your fingers are a bit sticky. Just head to the security and location section and then dive down and you'll find the face unlock option. Now, what you do is it just scans your face. As you can see, it's a very quick and simple process, and that just allows you to use your face, your beautiful mug, in order to log in instead. So for instance, we just try switching off, switch it back on, and it should scan my face, and there you go, we're straight back into the phone without even touching the fingerprint sensor. It seems to work pretty well so far. We've just had a bit of preliminary testing so far, and it seems to do the job quite nicely, so we definitely recommend turning that on as an alternative. Now, another worthy feature that you might not know exists is the Moto Key feature, tucked away again inside of that Moto app. Just give that a tap. What this allows you to do is basically replace your passwords and logins with just a quick scan of your fingerprint on that sensor instead. You'll need to sign in with a Lenovo ID, and once you've done that, any apps that you have signed into will then pop up here at the bottom. Now, if you already use Google Autofill, you find that you might have to go to the settings part of Moto Key, and you'll find something in here saying Manage App Passwords. Just give that a little tick, and that will basically override Google and make Moto Key the default autofill. You'll also find that any websites that you've excluded from Moto Key will appear in the exclusions list. If you want to undo that, you can just dive back into the settings and take them out again. So for instance here, I've just logged into Twitter. You'll see here, save username and password to Moto Key. We'll hit save. And now just touch the fingerprint sensor, and that has now saved our fingerprint for Twitter. So every time we want to log into Twitter, we can then just use our fingerprint instead of having to type in that clunky password. And now a couple of quick camera tips and tricks. First of all, did you know that you can activate the camera at any point, even when the G6 is hibernating, simply with a quick double twist of your wrist? Come on, there we go, get there in the end. And once you're actually in there, you can take a quick snap at any point as well by using the volume rockers, rather than having to tap that on-screen button if you prefer a bit of physical feedback. If you don't like the way your subject's framed or anything, you can dive into manual mode, and you can just play around with the likes of the white balance, ISO levels, all that kind of stuff, so you can get the shot looking just the way you want it, and you can just dive straight back into auto mode at any point that you want. Don't forget that you can also flick up the screen to dive into the special photo and video modes. One of our favourites in there is the spot colour. So for instance, if I tap on this here bottle, as you can see, then blue images are the only ones that remain. Everything else is in glorious monochrome. Tap the reset button, tap on the banana instead. That then reduces the amount of shade of the blue and everything, so the yellow is the predominant colour. And you can play around with that and get some freaky effects on the go. It's very funky. There is also this new object recognition feature as well. So if we get rid of the water bottle, bring in the banana and give that a bit of a tap, it will then focus on the banana and hopefully we will get some banana related information and web links. Or alternatively, it'll just think it's a pair of Nike trainers. Interesting.
Smushed inside the Moto G6's sexy glass frame is Qualcomm's Snapdragon 450 chipset, an affordable platform launched almost a year ago now. This is backed by 3GB of RAM and the result is quite satisfying performance. Although last year's Moto G5S Plus still beats this handset in benchmarking scores, we only saw the occasional little stumble and freakout. You can even multitask with split screen mode without too much in the way of stuttering. And if you like to get your game on, then the Moto G6 should just about suffice as well. The likes of PUBG played perfectly fine on the low detail levels, with only the odd little miss frame. And of course, if you're going to do a lot of gaming, we definitely recommend checking out the Plus model instead, which will offer smoother performance. Battery life on the G6 is even better. On a full charge, this phone will last through even the most demanding of days. We're talking a couple of hours of sat-nav action, plenty of camera use, and a fair bit of video streaming and gaming thrown in too. If you're a bit more reserved, the G6 will last up to 2 days quite happily before you finally need to plug it in. And with Motorola's Turbo Charge tech on board, the G6 will power back up in no time at all. Just over an hour at the plug is enough to fully fill that 3000mAh battery.
Like the Moto X4 and the G5S Plus before it, the G6 sports a pair of camera lenses sat there side by side on the back end. The primary 12 megapixel shooter is backed by a secondary 5 meg snapper, and this doesn't offer optical zoom or a wide angle view of the world, it's simply there to allow Motorola's portrait mode to produce a proper depth of field.
You can shoot full HD video at up to 60 frames per second, and there are quite a few nifty little bonus features thrown on as well, such as the funky spot colour mode.
So it looks like dual lens smartphone cameras are basically here to stay. Even our budget blows are rocking 2 lenses instead of 1 these days, and the fresh new Motorola Moto G6 is no different. Like the Moto X4 and the G5S Plus before it, the G6 sports a pair of camera lenses sat there side by side on the back end. The primary 12 megapixel shooter is backed by a secondary 5 meg snapper, and this doesn't offer optical zoom or a wide angle view of the world, it's simply there to allow Motorola's portrait mode to produce a proper depth of field. More on that bad boy later. You can load up the camera app at any time, even when the G6 is hibernating, with a quick double twist of your wrist. Not exactly an ideal manoeuvre if you suffer from carpal tunnel, for example, but hey ho. Alternatively, if you don't want to look like a bit of a plank, you can simply just poke that app icon instead. Nice. You're thrust straight into the auto mode, ready to snap away using the on-screen shutter button or that volume rocker. Photo capture isn't exactly super nippy, so the G6 isn't quite ideal for action shots, but it's not too troublesome either. You can quickly flip to the video mode or to those bonus features with a swipe up or down the display, while the main screen also houses a number of nifty shortcuts and tools. For instance, you can pop up some handy manual controls if you want to tweak the white balance or fiddle about with the shutter speed at any point. Motorola has also included an active photos mode, which basically mimics the likes of live photos and living images found on other smartphones. This can bring your gallery to life when you're flipping about, which is a neat enough effect if you spend lots of time snapping your kiddiewinks or your pets. And for the everyday shots, we found that the Moto G6 basically performs to the same level set by other budget handsets, such as the Honor 7C and the Huawei P20 Lite. As long as lighting conditions are fine and your subject isn't jumping all over the place like a hyperactive puppy, you can expect some pretty good results. Shots are packed with detail, while colours are accurately reproduced. Snap and vibrant scenes often results in some pretty attractive pics, with no kind of artificial touching up or anything. However, if you are trying to snap a child or something else with a mind of its own, you'll definitely want to take a few photos just in case. Quite a lot of our pics came out blurry when moving subjects were involved. And if lighting conditions are a bit off, the Moto G6 still does its best to compensate. Scenes with a high dynamic range are handled reasonably well, although you will definitely notice some oversaturation in those lighter areas. And while the f1.8 aperture means plenty of light is sucked into the lens for those darker moments, you'll still find that some dimly lit scenes come out quite grainy. Good thing that there's a flash then. Speaking of flashes, you can also shoot some glamorous selfies using that 8 megapixel front facing camera, which actually comes packing a flash of its own, so you can Instagram yourself having an awesome time up in the club. Like the rear-facing camera, however, this snapper once again struggles with imperfect lighting conditions. The Moto G6 sadly cannot shoot at 4K Ultra HD resolution, although it does support full HD at either 30 or 60 frames per second. If you want a bit of that 4K action, you'll have to upgrade to the Plus model. Still, detail levels are again strong at that full HD level, so your home movies will definitely look reasonably sharp when viewed back on your telly. Strong light can again result in oversaturation, and you can expect a fair bit of lens flare on a sunny day. But still, that lens does adapt well to changes in focal distance, and the digital image stabilization helps to cut down on any annoying juzzer. This is typically stronger at 30 frames per second, although a footage at the maximum 60fps setting wasn't too rough. Motorola has also done a bit of a wowie and absolutely stuffed the G6 full of bonus camera features. So for instance, right there on the main camera screen, you have access to the object recognition tool, which can analyze anything that you shoot and provide links for more information or to buy something similar. This is very much a hit and miss tool in real life, however. Sometimes it can accurately guess what it's seeing, helped along considerably by any visible logos or labels that you snap. However, most times you get a vague set of results, such as yellow lamp or green plant, and other times it is just downright wrong. Flip into the modes window and you'll find plenty more to play around with. Our old favourite, the spot colour feature, is thankfully back to instantly produce those poser Instagram pics that wedding photographers in particular seem to really love. And likewise, there's slow motion and time-lapse video modes, which do basically what they say on the tin. However, it's Motorola's version of the portrait mode which most intrigued us. This feature uses both lenses to lock on your subjects and then blur out the background to really help them to stand out. You can even change which part of the photo is in focus in post-edit if it didn't quite come out right. The results are usually pretty good, although we did find that our subject's silhouette was often a bit soft or blurred. The cutoff point isn't quite as accurate as some competitors, such as Huawei Manage. All the same, considering that budget asking price, these are definitely some attractive snaps. The Moto G6 is another great entry in Motorola's value pack smartphone family. That sleek redesign gets a big thumbs up from us, while the vanilla Android experience is backed by some worthy Moto features. And while the performance is limited, this handset will prove perfectly satisfying to most everyday users. So those are my in-depth thoughts on the Moto G6 after using it as my full-time personal handset for over a week. Go check out our full unboxing and camera review for everything else that you need to know about this bad boy, and we're also going to be fully reviewing the Moto G6 Play and the Moto G6 Plus as well to see how they all compare. Thanks for watching, everyone. Don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell for more reviews of the latest and greatest handsets. Cheers.